This is huge news, massive ramifications for Australia's biggest spectator sport, the AFL. And the man driving a proposed class action on concussion damages says he's not surprised at all about today's revelation that former AFL great Graham Polly Farmer had CTE. He describes the disease as a waiting game and says changes need to be made to the code to make safety the number one priority. Veteran AFL player agent and concussion advocate Peter Jess joins us now from Melbourne. Good morning to you, Peter.
Good morning.
So no surprise to you at all, Peter, this news?
No.
Why is that?
Well, what we know is that it can only be diagnosed post-mortem. So while we have a raft of ex-players who are still alive, there has not been the process to have their brains harvested so that we can actually check, you know, the clinical damage.
You've declared the game at the moment as it is unsafe, and the AFL met last week to tighten protocols on concussion, which forces concussed players to take a week off before that next game. Is that enough, do you think? Is the AFL doing enough?
No. I mean, look, we presented to, you know, the AFL medical and, you know, clinical evidence that said the window of vulnerability for players who have been clinically, you know, concussed is 4 to 6 weeks. If you return them to play in 7 to 14 days, which is what this, you know, proposal is, then the vulnerability level is that if they get another, you know, concussion, it is likely to be threefold that of the first one.
Yeah, and it can take 20 to 30 days for these players to get back to normal, which I was reading earlier this morning. But you also have big concerns about women playing the game and children as well.
Well, what it is that, you know, the game of football is a men's construct. It was first created so that men could legitimately go and belt each other. They put a circle around it, and what ostensibly would be a violent act which they would be charged for in any other setting, they can then carry out inside this circle. Now, it's morphed from a men's game to a women's game to a kids' game without the requisite detail for safety for each of that different cohorts with body sizes, et cetera, et cetera.
And I know you're leading a charge for a class action against the AFL, Peter. That's big. I mean, you've already said that it would be better spent on research, that money, but where are you at? Where are you at with that class action?
Look, one of the issues that we have is under the Medical Records Act in Victoria, once a player turns 32, it means every club can legally, and doctors can, you know, destroy the medical records. So, you know, the clinical evidence that is vital in our case is generally been destroyed. So it's a long, hard road. What I'm saying to the AFL is this: we need a better process where we can look at every player, look and see what they need in terms of if they can't work, then we should look at a, you know, support base for that. And if they're permanently damaged, then they should be compensated at a fair level.
Absolutely, Peter. I've got to agree with you on that. Let's hope we get this sorted. The start to the season isn't too far away. Thank you so much for your time, Peter.
Okay, pleasure.